Our newest update, version 20.1, ships with a number of new Xamarin Forms related features and products. If you're new to our Xamarin Forms product line and would like to review our What's New webpage, please point your browser to devexpress.com/new to learn more. In this video, I'll describe our new Xamarin Forms data form component and our data editors library and demonstrate how you can leverage the combined capabilities of these new Xamarin controls to deliver intuitive user experiences for your mobile world. Before I get started, let me jump to our What's New page and review some basics about our data form and data editors library. Once I have the What's New page loaded up, I'll click Xamarin to drill down into Xamarin-specific features in our version 20.1 update. I'll scroll past new chart and grid-related features and stop here at the data form. As you can see, our data form control allows you to generate Xamarin data edit forms for any object. I'll show you just how this works in a minute. If I keep scrolling, you'll notice that this release includes a feature-complete text editor, a multi-purpose data editor with built-in validation, mask, and error indication support. We also ship a new password editor, a multi-line text editor, and a combo box with lots of customization options, including configurable border colors and drop-down, up icons. Okay, with that brief overview, let me go to Visual Studio and begin this tutorial. The purpose of this overview will be to demonstrate how to generate and customize an edit form for any data object via our new data form component for Xamarin Forms. My app will be used to display employee information, so I need to create an employee info class that defines the data I want to display and edit. Pretty straightforward. Once I've got my class, my next step is to add a data form view instance to the application page and set the view's data object property to the employee info object. Again, straightforward. Let me run this app and see what I've produced so far. All right, as you can see, the DevExpress data form view automatically generated the data editors used within this app. These data editors were auto-selected based on the property types of the associated object. For instance, data form view used our Xamarin text editor for all string type properties such as first name. Since department includes a list of predefined values, the data form view automatically used our Xamarin combo box for the department field. Finally, data form view used a data picker for the app's hire date field. Very cool. Oh, a quick note. Our Xamarin data editors were implemented using material design guidelines. So my basic Xamarin data entry form was generated for me automatically. It's time for me to customize the data entry form. I'll switch back to Visual Studio to demonstrate. To customize behavior, I'll apply special attributes to the properties of my employee info class. As you can see, each attribute includes properties to control data editor specific settings. For example, I can set editor placeholders, and I can use a masked editor with the desired input mask for telephone. I can also use a numeric keyboard for the phone and zip code properties. Finally, I can assign the multi-line editor to the notes property. I also want to associate a photograph with each employee. To display an employee photo, I'll use a custom editor, an image inside of frame. In the XAML markup, I'll add data form custom item to the data form view.items collection, set its field name to photo path, and specify the editor view. To improve readability, I'll now organize my data editors into individual groups. To incorporate groups into my app, I'll add the data form display options attribute before each employee info class property. I'll then specify the group name parameter. Okay, time to run the app and see where I am so far. As you can see, I now have an image editor at the top of my form, and all my Xamarin data editors are grouped by individual categories. The phone field includes an input mask and will display numeric keyboard when a user begins input. It's now time to customize my form's appearance. I want to change appearance for editors, data group headers, and my app's row separators. All customization-related settings for the data form are split into two groups. The first group affects editors, and the other affects a group or data form itself. The first group of settings is managed by resources, predefined values associated with unique string keys and stored in the app resource dictionary. To change the appearance of all editors that the form displays, I override these resources. For example, to hide box borders, I set the DX text edit base border thickness and DX text edit base focused border thickness resource values to 0. Like other Xamarin.Forms UI controls, DataForm ships with both light and dark themes. The default values associated with resources are based on the currently applied theme. DataForms properties control the second group of settings. For example, I use the content padding property to specify both editor and separator padding within a group. I use the row separator color property to change separator color. Before I wrap up, let me add a validation rule to verify email formatting during data entry. I've already added system.componentModel.annotation's NuGet package to my solution. To apply the validation rule, I'll use the regular expression attribute and then select the appropriate validation mode when my editor loses focus. Our data form view supports multiple commit modes. I'm going to enable lost focus mode and commit values when the editor loses focus, assuming, of course, that the value first passes validation. To actually populate this data form with data, I'll bind to an instance of employee info. Let me run the application one last time. As you can see, all my editors are now customized. If we try to enter an invalid email, the data form now displays an error icon. If a value passes validation, it is automatically committed to the data object. I hope you've enjoyed this brief tutorial on our new Xamarin.Forms data form component. The DevExpress Xamarin.Forms component library ships as part of our universal subscription. For more information on this and other DevExpress Xamarin.Forms controls, please visit devexpress.com/Xamarin. If you like this video, please leave us a thumbs up or post your comments or questions below. And don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell to have access to more great DevExpress videos. Thanks for watching, and thank you for using DevExpress.